everybody. Welcome back. This is Tinker77. We are playing today in Hermitcraft Skies. This is going to be a hosted server series. The regular people who are my other servers are going to be joining me. There'll be Chevro and Candy and Thomas and Kent and Pause Player 10. The regular people that I have in my other videos. So, why am I doing this now? And the reason is that the Fullcraft server has been really lagging and crashing a lot, and during our last stream we had a long discussion with many of the people in the audience and with some of the other people on the server, and it was kind of decided we needed to do something else. And lo and behold, Hermitcraft Skies came out, and I thought, wow, that looks pretty cool, to see if I can get that on the server. And so I did. So we're gonna start this out. Nobody even knows about it yet, so I'm the first one here, and that means we get to do what we want pretty quick. I've only watched a couple of videos that the Hermits have done, so I don't know a lot about this yet, but I know enough that I can get started. So, yeah, we're going to do that in just a minute. I just wanted to say thank you for sticking with me on this. I'm hoping that this series will be something that you'll enjoy. Please let me know if you do, okay? So, I'm thinking I'm going to go over here to this right here, this black and yellow kind of looking flying saucer here. And I'm going to go up into it. Now, as far as I know, you just go into this liquid and it transports you up. So here we go. And can't get in there or something? Or is it blocked? Oh, I'm already at the top. Haha, okay. And we come out. And there we are. We're up inside like a little spaceship here. Okay. And then you get out by just going down there, I assume. Boy, that's a scary drop, isn't it, if you fall off. Okay, so welcome, traveler. To claim this ship, shift right click on the screen, then click the text button, rename however you'd like. Okay, we're gonna do this, and we're gonna do the text is, let's see, let's make this, what are we gonna call this? Can I erase it all? Okay. Tinker77. And then all the rest of this I want to just clear. Is this a clear button? Is there a way to clear it all really easily? Not really, you just gotta have to delete it all. Okay. We're going to do that really quick, and then we're going to go over to the next area. There we have our sign, Tinker77, welcome to my base. And we can change Wellome, I can't even type. Oh my gosh, I can't have that. Let's change that. Can I go in here and change it? Oh my gosh, how embarrassing, I can't even spell. Welcome. There we go. Welcome to my base. I could edit this out, but I probably won't. I'll just include it, let you have a little laugh at my expense. I want to check out getting out of here. Can I drop and not die? Okay, slime block. But I have to be careful exiting because I could just jump right off. But that's how you get out. Good. Okay, so let's go on to the next area, which is our island. My island. Okay, now we're all the way up. It's a little bit difficult. That's okay. And we're going to right-click on this. And here we are. I've been transported to an island. Let's see the biome type on here. We're in a savanna. It looks pretty cool. The green's kind of icky, but that's okay. So now, this has a lot of quests, and I've done just a smidge first. But if I go into the quest area here, you've seen this before probably on other people's videos and on mine. You go to quests, and you go to the first tab, Welcome to Light. You can see that this right here is the only one we're currently working on, Random Acts of Kindness. And Random Acts of Kindness, and just giving you your starting items. So you check this box, you text it, and you should be able to claim. You pick a loot box, doesn't matter. You pick one, doesn't matter. Pick that one and claim it, and there we go. Now, quest complete, random acts of kindness. The good thing is that this gives us a tree that we can start to work on planting and getting materials, just like that. I'm going to put a torch down. Let's put it right down here. Okay, now, just like in some of the many other mods you've seen, you can twerk to grow trees. This has a similar tool to the vein miners. I have it set up, so I hold a key and it presses it, and then all of those drop. Look at all that stuff. Excellent. Wow, we got a lot of saplings from that. That was excellent job there. Okay, now we're gonna plant another tree. We're gonna get some more wood. We're gonna do this for a little bit so we can get some resources before we really get started here. And it's dark, so we gotta be very careful. Let me get some more wood. All right, I got a lot more wood. We're good to go here. I'm going to make here the good old crafting table. We'll set that up somewhere over here, probably. Okay, now, look at the quests. One of the quests we have to do here, you can see that here's what we did, and it's green. We can do this or this. I'm going to go down here, early cobble, get 64 cobblestone and a furnace, and then we get this complete. Well, to get cobblestone, if you go to a dirt block, any dirt block will do, and if you shift and right-click on it, you get pebbles. Now, you pick up the pebbles here, and then you take those pebbles, and you make cobblestone. It's pretty easy. So I'm going to do that for a little bit here. You can hold it down, it goes a little slower, but if you go faster, you can get more. We've got a bunch there. Yep, okay. So we'll just keep on going here. If you had enough, you could have just gotten, you know, 64 right away. There we go, get some more pebbles. It's not that hard to do. There we go. Let's see how much. Do we have 64 cobble yet? 46, probably not. 55, we're getting close. Let's do it. Jam it on the right mouse button. Okay, that should do it for us. Good. Okay, so we got all this cobblestone here, and we got some extra. That's excellent. So let's go get a furnace. And there we go. Now, the quest is complete. I'm going to put the furnace down right there. And we get to go and we get to open up the loot chest that we get here in just a second. I didn't open up the first one, actually. Okay, so we're going to go in here. This is completed. We get to pick a reward. I'll go with the first one, claim it, done. Just like that. So now we have these loot chests. And let's see what's in the first one that we got when we did the starting materials. We got draconium-infused obsidian. Excellent. Now see, that goes right into my inventory. I don't have to do anything special. So open up the other loot chest. We got 4 carat plus. Looks like it gives haste. That's pretty cool. At least cool sounding. So yeah, now we got all this set up. I'm gonna make really quick here. I wanna make just a regular old chest. So I can start to store some of this stuff, and I'm gonna put it right on top of the crafting table. Okay. There we go. So we're going to start on some of the other things now, which is going to be, let's see what the next quest says to do. Let's go back here. The other one we had to do here is the wood age. Basically getting wood, getting saplings. Looks like we need to get more apples. Okay, all those have been completed. And that's just getting more trees. Now, one of the things that I saw, and I wanted to try this out, is if you have, let's see if I can do this right. Go get the saplings again. I just saw this today. I think I only need one sapling. But if you go into the crafting table and you have 3 apples and an oak sapling, it'll give you an apple sapling. Now this, when it grows, if it grows, will make an apple tree, and then you get lots of apples. If it grows. It should grow. Why isn't it growing? I don't know. Anyway, that's what I've seen from a video. Let's make sure this doesn't... I'll wait for a second. If it doesn't work, then I'll just try to figure out. But that should make an apple tree. We get lots of apples, and it should be easy. So let's see how this goes. Okay, I had the apple tree here. It didn't seem to work. I thought maybe it's because of this. So I moved it over here, and you can see it's got apples. And there they are. They just drop. But the nice thing is if you twerk, you get more. You can just grab them and go. How's that for cool? Not only do we have apples, but we have food sources. And now we can get this quest done. There we go. It should be enough. There it is. The wood age is complete. Let's go out there and see what that gets us. Okay, well, we've got that. Let's claim. I'm going to go with the first one. There we go. So that's what we're going to do for a little bit. We're going to start to do some of these quests and see what we get. But we have a nice apple tree. Oh, I love it. Let's see what's in here. Pulsating iron. That's not bad. That's not bad. We got off to a good start. So let me do a couple things here, and then I'm going to be right back, and we'll keep on working it on Hermitcraft Skies. Okay, so what I want to do here is I want to start to get some of the silkworms so that we can basically get the tree infested, and then after that we can get some string, and with string we can get the meshes and make things for beds, that sort of thing. So really that's the next step I want to do here. So I'm going to get a crook, and I'm going to go in here by going in with the wood we have here. Let's make a couple of these. And there's one. I think I do another one. Yes. And as you can see, the thing got out and people are now on here. What color did I go with? I went with yellow. Okay, so there we go. Okay, we're going to go up here. We're going to go and do this. We should have some silkworms. Excellent. Okay. And now we're going to go and get this tree. We're going to plant another one, grow it, and we're going to infest it with the silkworms so that that way we can get the strings. Here we go. You go like that, and then you just put this stuff inside the tree, different places. And we just got to wait, and then it'll come back, okay? So while it's waiting, what we're going to do is we're going to do the other part of this particular quest we're going to make is the sieves. And let's see here. Okay, let's figure out how to do that. What is the recipe for that? The sieves take the slab and two sticks. Okay, so that's pretty easy for us here. So we'll do, let's see. I want to make a bank of 9 of them. So let's do that. Let's get a bunch of these. Uh-oh, ominous music. And there we go. We got 9 of them. Okay, where'd it go? Did I just drop it? Okay. Now I'm going to put that right here. Not right there, but that'll work. Okay, and that way we can get this set up and ready to go. Okay, so, wow, look at that. That's all done. Let's get the crook. Let's get this one. And we have all that string. Excellent. Now we just got to make the mesh. So let's make the mesh here. It's this one. Takes that. That's pretty easy, so let's do that. Okay, so basically it's... Wish there's a way to equalize it out, but... I guess it didn't equalize out the way I wanted to. Okay, come on. 7 of them, that's not bad. I'll have to do this again here. Okay, so let me... Okay, we got that achievement there. Okay, let me get this here. And there we go. We'll do it one more time so we get this whole bank and then we'll be ready to go. So let me go do that. Okay, I think I've got everything I need here. Make a couple more of these meshes, and that will get that done. One more set. Okay. Okay, there we go. Like that. Now, I also have enough so I can make a bed, and I really want to get a bed, so... I need to get wool. There we go. Put that across there. The old standard vanilla recipe, and we have a bed. I'm going to put that over here for now. Okay, there we go. Sleeping. Hopefully that'll work out. And everybody will be happy that it's daytime again. Unless it doesn't let you sleep like that. Oh, man. So it's not. So you can see the stars barely moving. Which means everybody has to be in their beds. Okay. That's bad. Anyway, we're going to go on here. Let's go back out here. See, we completed this. Should give me the visibility to claim one. There we go. We got another quest done. Let me see what this one is. More draconium-infused obsidian. Excellent. Okay. The next thing I'm going to do is I want to get a lot of cobblestone so that I can make it into gravel. And then once I have it in gravel form, I can then get some flint, and we can try to get up to the flint meshes, which will give us more resources. We're just kind of working our way there. I'll grab it. Okay, there we go. So basically, I've got 4 stacks of 64. That's 64 of these. There we go. We have 64 cobblestone. So now what I need to do is I need to get a wand. A builder's wand is good. I'm going to use the diamond. This is pretty standard stuff here. Make the wand. Okay, there we go. Now, how am I going to do this? Well, I'm going to find a spot where I can put it, and I'm going to do a 4x4 area here. I can't do that one. That's okay. Thought I could. And where is my wand? Okay, here we go. This way, and we're just going to go up. Excellent. Okay, now that I've done that, I want to get a hammer. So let's see if we can go in here. Let's just make a standard old hammer. I believe it's just like this. No, is it this way? There it is. There's the hammer. And we're going to hit that, and it should give us gravel. So here we go. 64 gravel. Okay, now we can take this gravel over here and hopefully get some flint. Let's see how we do. See, you can do 9 at a time, which is nice. And it's going through sifting the gravel, getting flint. And then if we get enough flint, we can make an upgraded mesh, which then gives us more material. So that's what we're trying to do right here. The particular achievement says just get a flint mesh. You look right here. That's what we're trying to do. Get a flint mesh. Okay, do we got 8 flint? Okay, so let's go over here. What does the flint mesh take? It takes a string mesh and 6 flint, which we can do that really quick. So let's you shift right click to get that out. We got this here. There we go. And that should give us an achievement. There it is. Okay, I'm gonna put this one. Actually, I'm gonna take this one out here. Hold on. Get on a spot that I don't have it. I'm gonna put it right in the center so that way it's always attached to whatever is with it. Okay, there we go. So we basically have to go get more and more flint out of doing this process so we get this entire bank done, and that way we'll be fully upgraded. Let's go see what we got for the reward. Okay, let's do the first one, claim it. There's our chest right there. Let's open it up and a zombie charm. Interesting. Okay, we're gonna put that away here. Okay, so I'm gonna spend a little bit of time until I get this completely upgraded. That'll be a little bit of time, but let me get that done. Okay, I'm on my last one here. We're gonna do this right now. Get that one out, we go over here, we put it in again, and we go and get the 3 and the 3 on the sides and get the other one, and there we go. There we have it. Now, all of these are now flint, and what I think about flint is that it gives you lots of other resources. You can see down here I've got iron ore pieces and all sorts of different pieces, and that's really, really cool. So I'm going through this. Let me finish up this gravel here really quick. And what I've been doing is I've been putting in the iron into here. So if I take the iron pieces that I have and I do that, little 4x4 square, you get iron ore chunks. You can put that right into the furnace, and there you have it. You have iron. So we can get various resources this way. As you can see, I've been collecting a lot of these as I go. So I've got a lot of iron and other resources. This is really, really great, okay? Put that in there too. So now we've done all of this. Now there is a next step on this one, and we might want to go to that to get this even more, even better, because as you go as a higher level of the mesh, it gives you more and more resources. Now if we look here, let's go look at the mesh. Okay, you can see what this one does here. Where is it? I don't know where it is. Anyway, this is what we want, iron mesh, okay? It's gonna take 6 of these times 9. So as long as we get that much iron out of this, we should be good to go. So I'm gonna switch these out to iron, and let me see how far I can get. Okay, we have this apple tree going on here, and apples are really good. If you look at them here, it's food it gives you here. You can see it gives me 2 of the meat sources or food sources and 1.5 of the saturation. But what we can do is we can make a pot with 4 iron right here. And now I put an apple into here, we get apple sauce. And this has 3 bars of food, but look at all the saturation. So now we have another food source. This is great, and it's easy to do. I just threw out my pot. So with our apple tree, we've got a lot of resources as far as food that we can eat. Let me get this more apples. There we go. See what I mean? We can just make what we need right here. We don't even have to have a crafting table. There we go. And I threw out the pot again. There we go. Excellent, excellent, excellent. I'm still going to have to get some more iron so I can get these 2 filled out, and then we're going to be ready to go. Now, we did get, I believe we got from here, we get another chest, and I'm going to claim that right now. Here we go. A ring of experience. Not sure what that does exactly. I think it stores experience. I'm not quite sure. We need to get some more iron, though, and some more things like that, so let me finish this out real quick. All right. Last one, shift right click, taking the flint mesh out there, And we should have six here. That's good. Go in here. Put it in. And here we go. Just like that. There we go. I'm going to finish up this set of gravel. Just like this. And there we go. Okay, so we've got a lot of resources now. We've even got some more diamonds, which is very good. Glad we have that. Okay, so let's put all this stuff away here. Okay, so let's see what else we can do inside of the quest book, okay? We did that one. The next one down, I believe, is diamond mesh. Huh, we don't have the diamonds for that. So let's move on here. Lava generation. Basically, we have to make, looks like a lava bucket. And basically, to get a lava bucket, we have to get a bucket, first of all, and get lava. And lava, we need to get a, I believe it's a stone, a crucible, maybe? Let's go look here. Is it a crucible? Yes. So we have to get it, basically make it crucible, which is from an unfired one, which means we're going to have to get clay. So clay takes water. Now, I know for sure there's a water source under here. So let me think how I'm going to do this, and I'll be right back. All right, it's getting very late, and I might not have much more time that I can do anything in the game at the moment. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to do this for the first part, at least, of trying to get the lava. And the first thing I did was I did create a bucket using three iron. That was easy. Now what I want to do here is I want to make a barrel. Okay, it's an oak barrel, and it takes a formula like this, and you have an oak wood barrel. Now this is what we can use for, I'm going to put it somewhere over here. Okay, so that we can put water, once you fill this up with water and then you put dust in, it will make clay, if that makes any sense, okay? So now we have to get water into it. And what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to make some bowls. Let's make two bowls. And this can store water so that we can take it out. Oh, well, not two bowls, but eight bowls. Okay, well then, also I'm going to make a very generic, just a pickaxe, so we can try to get down to where the water source is. It's under here somewhere. So we're going to go in. And there's the water source. Now we use the bowl. You can see it gives water. Bowl of water. And you can take that over here and you can kind of fill it up. And there we go. Now all we need to do is just get some dust. And to get dust, basically you take a hammer onto some cobblestone. So here's a cobblestone. You hammer it once. It's now gravel, and just like you did in Sky Factory, hit it again, it's sand. One more time, it is dust. Dust in here, and we have clay, just like that. That was pretty easy. We can even do that all again, and we'd have enough to make our crucible, I think. Maybe it's not so hard. Okay, let's do that again. I need a piece of cobblestone. I had enough of the pebbles with me, so that's good. So we'll just do that again here. Little grindy, but that's okay. It's a lot of fun. Here we go. Here's the dust. And there we go. Now, with this, if you hit this with a hammer, it makes clay. And there we have what we need here. I believe we just do this. Oh, wait. It's got to be fired. Is that right? Maybe I got this wrong. Let me make sure I got this right. Okay. The crucible, the unfired one. Oh, I think we might need bone meal to make these. It's porcelain clay, which takes bone meal. Did we get any bone meal at all? No, I don't see any bone meal. So I got to figure out how to get bone meal next, and that's probably going to take me a little more time than I have tonight. Let's just go look real quick, see if there's anything that tells us how we get it. From bones. Looks like if we put dust through the mesh. Okay, so we got to put dust through it. Let me gather a whole bunch of dust and then we'll try this out and see if we can do it. Okay, we're going to use the wand on the sand. Oops. A little lag there, I think. Go up on the sand. Okay, we got the whole thing done. We're going to hammer it. I think it's a stack of dust. We're going to go over here and we're going to try... I'm worried I'll run into a resource trouble. You saw everything was going everywhere here. So I'm going to try to free up as much space as I can before I do any more of this, because I want to make sure I grab it all, so. Because everything's just flying all over the place, as you saw there. And hopefully we'll get enough bone meal. I see one bone meal, that's good. We need 7 bone meal total. We have 5, excellent. 8, excellent, very good. And there we go. Okay, so we have, to go back into here, we have our clay, and we have our bone meal. Okay, and there we go. 8 of those, excellent. Now we can make our crucible. And there it is, and then we just throw it into here, take the iron out. Hopefully that's enough wood. Should be. Okay. And there it is. Excellent. Now, to heat this, you have to put it above a heat source, which we're going to use a torch. I'm going to put it right... let's see. Let me get rid of this. Where's my pick? I put everything away. Now I don't have everything in my inventory. Okay, I'm going to put the torch here. I'm going to put this on top of it. Okay. Now this, we have to fill up with cobblestone. Do I have any more pebbles left? I do. Okay, so let's see. I'll do this real quick. There we go. That's enough cobblestone. I'm going to put this in here, and you can see it fills up. Okay. And slowly, it turns the cobblestone into lava. And then all we need to do is just grab it with a bucket. Okay, so I'm going to wait for just a little bit, and I'll come right back, and we'll do the lava. Okay, we've got a bunch of lava in there. Let's see if we can get any of that out with the bucket. And yes, we do. We have enough. As you can see, we got that, and we got a completion. So there we go. We're going to go, and we're going to go and claim. Let's do the middle one. Excellent. Okay. Now, one thing I can do here is I can get rid of this block real quick. Maybe this block too. Okay. And what I can do is I can put lava underneath this here. Now, see, right now it says the rate is 0x, but if I put lava underneath, it should flow. And now it has a 3x rate, which is really good. And then we can put above this, we can put another... another one of these crucibles, so we can make more lava. Okay, so that's about all I'm going to do for tonight as far as this goes, and probably for this video. So right now I'm going to go and cut this clip. The next clip, we're going to go and see what the other guys have done. Okay, I'm getting ready to go, but I want to open this loot chest first, so let's see what that is. Another ring of experience that we don't need. Okay, let's go on back here. There we are, we're back at our base. We can walk out here. Now apparently, oops, ouch, that hurt. They took gray and they took black. So I think that one over there is gray. Let's go see. Looks kind of gray, doesn't it? Let's go see who this is and see what they've done. Okay, this is Candies. Candy looks like Candy's got a good apple tree, some chests, and he's got his, he probably doesn't even know I'm here. Got some cauldrons going. He's got, oh, he's already got lava, too. There we go. Just saying hi. Okay, so he's not doing bad. He's got about this kind of the same, similar ideas. He's got some storage. This already, this is a cobblestone generator already. No, it's not. He just has the storage for storage drawers. Okay. Lots of apples. Got a lot of stuff going on. Pretty good, Candy, if you watch this video. Pretty good. Applesauce. Yep. I see it. Okay. Well, I don't think I'm going to give him a message. We'll just go. Okay. Yeah. Have some applesauce. Okay. Okay. Now let's go find... Kent. So you run out here. Kent took black. And I believe it's over a ways. And we're going to see where that is. It's over this way. There's like a little town here. We got speed boost, but not. But anyway, right over here, I believe, is black. And you can kind of see I don't have my magnifier feature, but over here it looks like someone else has put their stuff in here. Kent's UFO of love. Okay, let's go in here. There's Kent. And it looks like he's got some storage systems going on. He's got his meshes he's working on. He's doing pretty good too. Big pimpin' over here. Gave him some applesauce since I have like 30 of them now. Cool. So yeah, he's already got some of the tinker tables going on. So everybody's doing the same kind of thing here starting out, but it's looking really good. Okay. It just looks funny. Okay, time for me to get back to base. Now I gotta remember what color I pick. What color I pick? I think I picked yellow. So let's go with the yellow. We'll get back to base. So while I'm on my way over here, I want to say, you know, if you like this new series, please leave a like. That's just critical that I get those likes. And put a comment. Let me know what you think. Whoa, that was fast. Okay, we'll go back over here. So let me know what you think about this. Do you like it? Is this a good thing? It seems not to be very laggy, which is good. Fullcraft was just terribly laggy, and it was really causing trouble. So that's why we kind of went away from that and repurposed the server for this, okay? Kent just fell. That's funny. Sorry, Kent. Rip. So if you'd like to subscribe to this channel, please do so. Don't forget to hit the little bell icon. I really appreciate more subscribers and telling everybody, you know, about Tinker 77 and what we're trying to do here. So yeah, I think that's about it. It's a little longer of a video. I'm really liking this. This is fun. It's kind of like a mix of Sky Factory with a mix of Fullcraft and some other things. So I really do like this so far. So let me know what you think, okay? Anyway, that's all I have time for today. Hope you liked the video. Have a great day. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.